Hello students, welcome in today's lecture. Now we are going to discuss the problems on genetic basis of inheritance. In our previous lecture we have seen the problems on the topic reproduction in plant. In this topic, for theory point of view, we have studied the Mendes experiment and the blood groups in the human being. So the examples mainly based on the monohybrid cross, probability of the gametes, and on the blood group of the human being. Here we'll discuss the first example, that is how many different types of gametes will be formed for the plant having genotype capital A, capital A, capital B, small b, capital C, capital C. Options are 1, B option is 2, C is 3, and D is 4. So the genotype of the plant is given, and by this genotype the question is that how many different types of gametes will be formed. So when such a question is asked, there is one formula that we have to apply in this example, and that is 2 raised to n. N means the number of heterozygosity. So if the genotype is given in the example, by this genotype we have to first find out the heterozygous pair of the gene. So here I have written below the formula the genotype of the plant, that is capital A, capital A, capital B, small b, capital C, capital C. If you observe the genotype, then there is only one pair of gene, that is capital B and small b, is a heterozygous pair, while capital A, capital A, and capital C, capital C are the homozygous pair. For the theory, we have seen that homozygous means having the similar alleles, capital A, capital A, similar alleles, capital C, capital C, similar alleles, that's why they are homozygous. But heterozygous means the dissimilar alleles, that is capital B, small b, these are the dissimilar alleles. So it is a heterozygous pair. From the genotype only one pair will be there, so value of n is equal to 1, because there is only one pair of the heterozygosity is there. When we apply it in our formula, 2 raised to n is equal to 2 raised to 1, and the answer is equal to 1, that is the 2. There is no need to write the genotype, and then we have to calculate their gametes, and then their F2 generation. Simply by the formula 2 raised to n, we can calculate the gametes of any genotype. So if this example is asked to your exam, then you have to observe first the genotype, and then by this genotype you can easily calculate the gamete by the formula 2 raised to n. So here the option B is correct, that is the 2 answer. Second example is given that how many types of gametes will be formed for the given type of genotype. Genotype is capital T, small t, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. So same example will be here, same type of question is here, but for our practice we have taken it. So see here, again we have to observe the genotype. So first there are 4 options are there. Option 1 is 1, option B is 2, option C is 6, and option D is 8. And by the genotype we have to find out the gametes. So we'll write first our genotype, capital T, small t, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r. By this genotype we can see that there are 3 pairs of heterozygous gene. First pair is capital T, small t. Second one is capital Y, small y. Third one is capital R, small r. So here the value of n is equal to 3. In first example, value of n is 1. But in this example, value of n is 3. So if we apply it in our formula, 2 raised to n is equal to 2 raised to 3. And the answer of it is 8, because 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. So here the correct option is D, that is the 8 answer is correct. And for your practice or for your homework, we have given the third example. So we'll read first the example, then you have to solve it in a similar way like the first and two example. So third example is, how many types of gametes will be formed for the given type of combination? Combination means for given type of genotype. And those are capital A, small a, capital B, small b, capital C, small c, capital D, small d. Here again you have to write first the genotype of the parent which is given in the example. Then by this genotype you have to find out the number of heterozygous pair, because those are only important for our example. We have to not focus on the number of homozygous pair. You have to calculate the number of heterozygous pair, apply it in a formula 2 raised to n, and then you will get the answer of the number of gametes formed by this genotype. So this example is given for your homework. Now we'll discuss the fourth example, that is, when dominant capital A capital A and a recessive small a are crossed with each other, the percentage ratio of hybrid showing parental genotype is. Students, see here, you have to first understand the meaning of the example. Here in first line, dominant capital A and recessive small a are crossed. That means these are the parents, because we always cross the parents. And if you observe, you will find that these are the two parents, because both are the homozygous. And when there is a homozygous parent, we call it as a true parents or the pure line parents. So in this example, the parent genotype is capital A and this small a. The percentage ratio of hybrid means after crossing the parent, the progeny that we will get in a F1 generation, that we call as a hybrid progeny. So here the question is asked that the hybrid which is produced by the crossing of the parent capital A and small a shows how many percentage of the parental genotype. त्या hybrid मध्ये parentचे genotype किती percentage आहे, parentचे genotype किती percentage आहे हे आपल्याला विचारलेलं आहे. मग यासाठी चार ऑप्शन दिले आहेत पहा. ऑप्शन ए 0%, ऑप्शन बी 25%, ऑप्शन सी 50% एंड ऑप्शन डी 75%. सो एग्जाम्पल इज व्हेरी इजी, बट नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट कॅनॉट गेट द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस एग्जाम्पल अँड दे कॅन सॉल्व इट. सो सी हियर वॉट वी हॅव टू डू फॉर दिस एग्जाम्पल. We have to first cross the two parents capital A cross with small a. Then after crossing of the parents, you will get the hybrid in F1 generation. And see in our example, one gene from the one parent capital A and other gene from other parent small a come together and they form the hybrid. So genotype of the hybrid will be capital A small a. So this is the hybrid. Now in question ask that percentage of this hybrid genotype with their parent, percentage of this hybrid to their parental genotype. So see here, parents are capital A, capital A, small A, small A. But there is no parent like capital A, small A. So hybrid phenotype is, or a hybrid gene is totally different from that parents. Okay, so here the first answer is correct, that is 0%, because hybrid is capital A, small A, but parents are not capital A, small A. So answer will be 0%. It's a very simple example. By such an example, you have to practice more examples from your CET book. Now we'll discuss the fifth example, that is a tall true breeding garden pea plant is crossed with dwarf true breeding garden pea plant. That means again it is an example of the monohybrid cross. Tall plant and dwarf plant, both are the true breeding, both are the pure. When crossed with each other, then you will get the F1 generation, that means F1 hybrid. But what is given in example, and F1 generation is a self cross. That F1 generation, after crossing the tall and dwarf pea plant, when self cross, that means there is a selfing of the F1 generation, and genotype obtained in F2 generation. That means in the question ask that pure tall and pure dwarf plant when cross in F1 generation, you will get the hybrid. By selfing of the hybrid, what is the offspring produced in the F2 generation have the genotype. So here F2 generation cha offspring cha genotype apnala vicharlele kay vicharlele ahe genotype. All of you are well known of the term phenotype and the genotype. Phenotype, that means the external appearance of the plant, while genotype means the genetic constitution of the plant. So here they have asked the genotype of the F2 generation, and we'll see the options. First, 3:1 tall genotype is 3:1 tallest to dwarf, 3:1 dwarfest to tall, 1:2, 2:1 homozygous tall, heterozygous tall, homozygous dwarf, and the D option is 1:2, 2:1 heterozygous tall, homozygous tall, homozygous dwarf. You have to read carefully all the four options, because by this option we have to find out the genotype of the F2 generation. Okay, so here first, by this example, we'll cross the tall and dwarf plant, then we will get the F1 hybrid. Then we have to make the selfing of F1 hybrid for getting the F2 generation, and by this F2 generation we will calculate the genotype of the F2 generation. So see here how we have to solve this. So for that, so see here in this example what we have to do, we have to cross first the pure parents, pure tall and pure dwarf. If we say that pure tall and pure dwarf, then the genotype of that parent will be pure tall, capital T, capital T, pure dwarf, small t, small t. Here, after crossing the pure tall and the pure dwarf plant, you will get the hybrid, that is called as a F1 hybrid. It is a monohybrid cross, so in the example we have written as F1 monohybrid. And the genotype of hybrid is capital T and the small t. You know that we have solved the examples of the monohybrid cross in the theory, and the hybrid of the monohybrid cross is capital T and the small t. In selfing, what we do? Capital T, small t, cross with again capital T, small t. And here you will get the gametes, and these gametes are taken on the checkerboard for the calculation of the F2 generation. But students, see here, the same hybrid will be there, that's why we here directly taken their gametes, that is capital T and the small t. And this gamete we have taken on the checkerboard by which we can calculate F2 generation. So see here, the two gametes will be there, capital T, small t. On one side we have written the capital T, small t, and on other side also we have written the same gamete, capital T and small t. And if we write inside the checkerboard, then what will be result? In first column, capital T, capital T, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, and the last will be small t, small t. So here, if you observe total tall plant and total dwarf plant, then total tall plants will be 3 and total dwarf plants will be 1. This is called as the phenotypic ratio. All of you know that phenotypic ratio of the monohybrid cross is 3:1. But in this example, we have asked the genotype of the F2 generation. So again, from the checkerboard, we have to take the pure tall, the heterozygous tall, and the pure dwarf. So see here, pure tall, capital T, heterozygous tall, capital T, small t, and pure dwarf, small t, small t. If you observe, pure tall is only 1, capital T, small t are 2, and small t are 1. So here you will get 1:2, 2:1 genotypic ratio of the F2 generation. So from above option, option C is correct, because in option C there is given that 1 is homozygous tall, 2 is heterozygous tall, and 1 is the dwarf plant. So option C is the correct. So this example is also very easy. By the selfing of the F1 hybrid, we can easily calculate the genotype as well as the phenotype of the F2 generation. So if the example is asked on this pattern, then we can easily calculate the genotypic ratio of the F2 generation. Okay, here overall these 5 examples we have studied based on the Mendel's experiment. And for CET point of view, such a type of examples are only asked which are easy based on the monohybrid cross. Now, the example that we are going to discuss is based on the blood groups. So, students, all of you are known that there are 4 type of blood groups: A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group, and the O blood group. You are well known for the genotype as well as the phenotype of the blood group, because we have seen that for blood group A, there are genotypes in homozygous form is called as capital I, capital A, capital I, capital A. And for heterozygous condition, the genotype of blood group A is capital I, capital A, and small I. Okay, so here we are going to solve the examples on the blood groups, similar type of genotypes like the blood group A. You will observe in blood group B, blood group O, blood group AB. So students, here now we are going to solve the examples on the blood groups. So we'll read first example, that is the genotype of husband and wife are capital I, capital A, capital I, capital B, and capital I, capital A, small I. So if we observe the example, then you will find that genotype of husband and wife are, so husband blood group is capital I, capital B, and the wife's blood group is capital I, capital A, small I. Okay, now here we know that the blood group of husband and blood group of wife, that is given in the example. So here, how many different phenotypes and genotypes are possible by the blood group of husband and wife? We have to ask that how many different phenotypes and the genotypes are possible. So see here, students, options are 4. First option, 4 genotype, 3 phenotype. Second option, 3 genotype, 4 phenotype. Third option, 4 genotype, 4 phenotype, 4th option 3 genotype, 3 phenotype. So here we have to calculate the number of genotype and number of phenotype from this example. Then how we'll calculate this? Now see here, we'll write the genotype of the parents. So husband blood group is capital I, capital A, capital I, capital B, and wife's blood group is capital I, capital A, small I. So first we have to find the gametes from the genotype. So the gametes of the husband blood group is capital I, capital A, capital I, capital B, and the gametes of the wife's blood groups are capital I, capital A, and small I. Here, for finding out the genotype and phenotypes of the blood group, we have to cross this blood group. So blood group capital I, capital A, first has crossed to, sorry, see again here, the blood groups of the husband, capital I, capital A, first should be crossed with the blood groups of wife, capital I, capital A. So here you can observe on the screen that how we have crossed this. The first is cross, first blood group, or first we'll see the gamete of the husband is crossed with the first gamete of the wife. Then first gamete of the husband is crossed with the second gamete of wife. Second gamete of husband is crossed with the first gamete of the wife. And second gamete of the husband is crossed with the second gamete of wife. All of you are known how the gametes are crossed with each other, and by which you have found there are four genotype. First is capital I, capital A, capital I, capital A. This genotype indicates the blood group A. So below which we have written the blood group A. Capital I, capital A, small I, by which you can observe that it is a blood group A. Third genotype is capital I, capital A, capital I, capital B, by which you can say that it is blood group AB. And the fourth one is capital I, capital B, small I, by which you can observe that it is a blood group B. So by this chart, what do you observe? That is, there are how many genotypes? Four. They are not similar. How capital IA, capital IA is a different. Capital I, capital A, small I is a different. Capital I, capital A, capital I, capital B is also different. And the last one is capital I, capital B, small I is different. So here you will get the four type of genotype. Okay. Now we'll observe the phenotype. But in the chart of the phenotype, you observe that there are two A blood groups, AB blood group and the B blood group. So no need to take the two A separate. So out of this two A, we'll take only A. So here you will observe that there are overall three phenotypes, which are A blood group, AB blood group and the B blood group. So here the correct option is 1. You can check later on, and which is the correct option 1? That is 4 genotype and the 3 phenotype, because the phenotypes are 3. Similar phenotype we have deleted, and there are 4 genotypes. So correct option is first. Now we'll read the 7th example based on the blood groups. A man with blood group A married a woman. A man with blood group A married a woman having blood group 13. Sorry, having a blood group B. You will get confused that it is not a 13, it is a B. Okay. So man's blood group A, he married with a woman having blood group B. What are the possible blood groups of their offspring? So here father's and mother's blood group is given, and by this blood group we have to find out the blood group of their offspring. Such a type of question is also asked number of time for our exam, so you have to also practice such type of questions. Here four options are given. First option, blood group A, B, A, B, O. Second, O only. Third, A and B. And fourth, A, B, A, B only. So students, how we have to solve this example? Because we know the blood group of parent by which we'll first calculate their genotypes, and by these genotypes you will find the possible blood groups of their children. So here we will see this example. Here the blood group of one parent is given, that is capital A. Blood group of other parent is given, that is capital B. So genotype of capital A in both homozygous and heterozygous condition will be capital IA, capital I, capital A, capital I, capital A. Second possibility is capital I, capital A, small I. The genotype of blood group B, capital I, capital B, capital I, capital B. And second combination is capital I, capital B, small I. It is a heterozygous. Student, there is no need to cross these gametes to each other, because you will observe that when the parents' blood groups are A and B, then definitely there is one trick by this blood group is that there will be four type of blood groups will be found in the children, and those are the A, B, A, B and O. So here if but the parents' blood groups are A and B, then there is no need to cross the gametes with each other, but you have to only identify the four blood groups A, B, A, B and the O. So by this the option A is correct, because in this A, B, A, B and O are the options, which is the first one correct. Here now we are going to discuss the problems on the probability. These problems are also important. They may be asked for our exam. So what is meant by probability? That means in this example, the genotypes of the parents are given, and by these genotypes, we have to find out the probability of the gametes. So in the example, capital A, capital A, capital B, small b, small c, small c, cross with capital A, small a, capital B, small b, capital C, small c. Here only one genotype is written below, capital A, small a, capital B, capital B, capital C, small c. Okay, so student, here we have to find out the probability of the genes in the up to generation. So see here how we have to solve it. So for that we have to draw the checkerboard. So see the first line, capital A, capital A, capital B, small c, cross with capital A, small a, capital B, capital C, small c. Then what you will observe that here we will focus on the first pair of the gene, capital A, capital A and capital A, small a. So here we will write it on a checkerboard, capital A, small a, capital A, capital A. We will write inside the checkerboard first capital A, capital A, then capital A, small a, then capital A, capital A, again capital A, small a. So see here the genotype which is written that is capital A, small a, capital B, capital B, capital C, small c. Here we have to find out the probability in this checkerboard of the gene capital A, small a. So here you observe that from the checkerboard there are two capital A, small a. So below that we have written that capital A, small a is equal to four offsprings are there, out of four two will be capital A, small a. So 2 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. So below the capital A, small a, we'll write here 1 by 2. Now we have to find the probability of the capital B gene in the parent genotype. So we'll focus on the again parents pair capital B, small b, capital B, small b. So see here in the second part we have written the parents genotype capital B, small b, capital B, small b. So what will be in checkerboard? First capital B, capital B, capital B, small b, capital B, small b, small b, small b. Now what we have to find? We have to find the probability of the genotype capital B, capital B. So here how many capital B will be there? Only one out of four. So capital B is equal to 1 by 4. And here we'll write below the capital B, 1 by 4. Now we have to find out capital C, small c. And by this, again we will focus on the last pair of the gene in the genotype of the parent. Small c, capital C, small c. So third will be given here. That is capital C, small c, small c, small c. So in first term, capital C, small c, small c, small c, capital C, small c, small c, small c. Here what we have to find? Capital C and small c. So how many capital C and small c will be there out of 4? 2. So 2 by 4, again we will write here 1 by 2. So here we have written it as a 1 by 2. We have to multiply it, and after multiplication there is the answer, that is 1 by 16. So student, have you got it? What I have told you, that when the genotype of the parents are given, then on one side again the genotype of or the gametes pair is given, and by that genotype we have to find how many gametes are similar, and by this we have studied the probability question. Now the similar question we will discuss here, and that is next one. Question will be there, small a, small a, small b, small b, capital D, small d, cross with capital A, small a, capital B, capital B, capital D, small d. Here again the at one end there will be genotype is given, and first we have to find out capital A, small a. So how we'll find out? So focus on first pair of the parents gamete, capital A, capital A, capital A, small a. We'll write here capital A, small a, small a, small a. Then here by this similar example, so I will repeat it fast. So here we have to find which pair, capital A, small a. So capital A, small a are 2 out of 4. So 2 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. So here below the capital A, small a, we have written 1 by 2. Now we'll focus on the parent genotype, small b, capital B, capital B. Again we have drawn here checkerboard, capital B, small b, small b. We have to find out capital B and small b pair. How many are there? 4. So 4 by 4 is equal to 1. Here we have written 1 by 1. Last one is that parent genotype, capital D, small d, capital D, small d. So here we have taken this on checkerboard, and you have to find out small d, small d. There is only 1, so 1 by 4, and it is written below this small d, small d. If we multiply it, then you will observe 1 by 8. So students, these are the some of the important examples which may be asked or always asked, not maybe, because if you see the previous question paper, you will get the questions on this type. So practice it. It is very important थैंक यू वेरी मच.